Hello YouTube, Cyclone is here, and I'd like to discuss the unfortunate candidates for the presidency of the United States. As we all know, basically Senators McCain and Barack Obama have initially sustained the nominations for their affiliated parties. What's basically left to do is basically the official nominations and an election. Now, of course, we're going to be subjugated, and yes, I mean that sincerely, subjugated to negative ad campaigns, which basically focuses on basically what the other candidate can or cannot do versus themselves. It's amazing to me that these candidates who say they love America and Americans are so willing to go on television and basically badmouth the other side, and rather than focusing on what they can do for the country, they badmouth the other person. And it shows, in a great reflection, that the more that they hit, or I should say, make fun of the other candidate, it shows that the candidate themselves does not have the proper, shall I say, backbone to actually say for himself that these are the issues that I'm working for. These are the issues I'd like to see happen. These are the issues I'd like to see fixed, and so on and so forth. But what's the common theme in all elections? To basically badmouth your opponent. And unfortunately, in the case of the American presidential elections, this will be the case. If I were my other compatriots out there in America, here in America, I should say, I would be demanding that these candidates actually speak what they can do or what they plan to do for America, not what they think they can do while bashing their opponent. If they're busy bashing their opponent, it shows you that basically they have really nothing else to say except to say, "Elect me because I think the other guy is a jerk." That's basically what the campaigns amount to. Now, the citizenry out there here in America should be insulted every time you see ads or advertisements like this that basically bash the other opponent. And in a nutshell, I've made a promise to myself. The next person or candidate that makes the other side look bad in an attempt to basically make themselves look good, then that candidate is basically not going to get my vote. So basically, you know automatically who will not be getting my vote, because let's face it, both sides will resort to bashing the other side. What's amazing to me is that In all the things that these candidates are saying, and what they want to do, so they say, you know, there's one candidate that I wish was still in the running. That candidate I wish was Ron Paul. Now, Ron Paul is a congressman from Texas, and he's a Republican. Now, keep in mind that I'm an independent voter, so normally I don't vote towards Democrat or Republican. So I vote based on the issues, not on the party. But Ron Paul here, he said something that no candidate during the debates, that is, bothered to say, and he said it so plainly and so elegantly that it made all the other candidates look bad. And basically, as a result, because he did not conform to the party line. Basically, he did not get the proper media coverage, and they made him look like a fool. But the thing that he said that was basically damaging was the truth. He said the truth, which no one, including corporate America and the American people, were not ready to hear. But we needed to hear it anyway. It's a truth that basically it's a reality. And as Americans and as people who vote, we are ignorant to this truth. Why? Because the media, in its infinite wisdom, wishes to shield you from that truth. And better yet, our very own government wishes to basically hide their truth from the American people. They did it during the Iraq War of 2003. They hid the truth so well that basically we were ready to go to war or basically invade another country for a premise that basically was a lie. And everyone knows it's a lie. I mean, it's common knowledge. But because the government and our leadership sold this lie, I mean, no, the American people bought it. Ron Paul, on the other hand, is a pragmatist and a person that spoke the truth. And to this day, he continues to speak the truth. Now, both candidates running for president right now, Obama and McCain, do not represent the truth. Now, of course, you'll hear that McCain stands for strong leadership, while Obama stands for youth and basically new ideas. But these are premises that are not new. They're so old, they're probably as old as the country. But Ron Paul, in my opinion, represents basically a truth that must be told. And it's unfortunate, very unfortunate, that the truth was not told or shared. What did the government and corporate media do in a marriage of convenience? They hid the truth by basically making Ron Paul look like a fool. And of course, not everyone is keen to catching on to this. This is a serious time for the country. And the country needs serious leadership. And unfortunately, I do not believe, and I repeat, I do not believe that Senator McCain or Senator Obama represent anything that the leadership needs. We need leadership that Ron Paul represents. Now, of course, people will say I'm crazy because I'm following a gynecologist and an obstetrician, but reality is, I'd rather follow someone like that actually speaks truth, truthfully, and without reservation, or without trying to fool you into believing some hopscotch idea that basically is a lie. Again, just my opinion, but of course, with the media out there, they'll be sure enough to hide it or make you believe that people who have the opinion of Ron Paul is crazy. Such is reality. Oh well. Ta-da!